Hey everybody, Brian
and Kelly
for Short-Circuited Brewers. I don't do a lot of like grain to glass videos, and you know, it takes so much time, and I'm not a patient person, am I?
No, it's not one of your greatest attributes for sure.
Right, exactly. I'm not a patient person, so. And you know, I'll brew, you know, you guys see me test systems and brew things and all that kind of stuff. And, a lot of times I don't share the outcome of the brew with you. You know, I might post something on Instagram or something like that, but this one actually came out really good. I wanted to share it with you guys and give you our impressions of it. Now we've already had some, you know, full disclosure on that, but I wanted to share it with you. And actually it was a really simple recipe that I put together. And I also want to say thank you to Yakima Valley Hops. They actually sent me the Lupomax Citra hops and the Eclipse hops. So this beer is called Total Eclipse of the Citra. So kind of a little 80s shout out throwback there. Kelly's an 80s girl.
Yeah.
And she's still wearing the hat. She's been wearing the hat ever since the live brew day. I mean, she wore it to bed. I mean, you can see it's kind of wrinkled up here a little bit and stuff. So
I like it.
It's one of those things.
They didn't say anything at the grocery store.
Yeah. So, you know.
Actually, nobody talked to me.
Hey, lady, Halloween's over. So I want to share the recipe with you real quick and kind of what my methods were whenever I brewed the thing. Let me get over here to the recipe real quick. So here's what was in the recipe. I had 6.4 ounces of Munich malt, which this was almost one of those things where I had some stuff laying around, so I just kind of threw it together.
Yeah.
Fortunately, I used the Brewfather app and did my inventory and all that stuff like I did a video on, and I'll put a card up here for you guys if you want to see what that's about. And so I knew what I had, and so when I did the recipe, I'll be able to make this thing again because I know exactly what I put in it. Because a lot of times those recipes, you know, you throw the kitchen sink in there and then you don't know what you put in. You get a good one and you're like, oh crap, what'd I do?
Yeah.
But I do know what I did on this one because of the Brewfather app.
Good.
So I had 6.4 ounces of Munich malt, and that was just kind of for a little bit of color really. 1 pound of flaked barley, 5.5 pounds of pale malt, pale ale 2-row, and 5 pounds of Pilsner malt. And 1 pound of honey malt. So then what I did...
Honey malt.
Yeah, so the honey malt kind of gives them a little bit of a sweeter flavor. Kind of.
Like
yeah,
there.
Maybe. And I've had that in some of the other New England IPAs, and so that's kind of why I put it in there, because I like the flavor that gives. And I did basically just a really small charge of Citra at the beginning. It was like 0.4 ounces, and that was a first wort hop. Basically, whenever I started collecting the wort from the Breweasy Compact Brew Day, I just threw in the hops in the bottom of the kettle and just let them steep while it was coming up to boil and all that stuff. And then no other hops at all. I did a 30-minute boil. And then I did 4 ounces of Eclipse and 4 ounces of Citra Lupomax in the whirlpool. Kind of used the hop spider and put them in there and just basically circulated everything through the hop spider, through the hops.
Did you say Lupomax?
Yeah, Lupomax. They're like I'd have to look on their website to describe it, but basically they extract mostly lupulin, which is the stuff that like the yellow powder you see on hops.
Okay.
And they make pellets with that rather than using a lot of the vegetative matter or the green stuff
cool.
in the hops. So they have, I mean, these things were like 20 IBU hops.
Oh,
I mean, they're really strong from that aspect. But then they're also really strong as far as aroma and flavor and all that stuff.
Is the honey malt hard to come by? I was just wondering.
No, it's not bad. I mean, it's pretty readily available everywhere.
Cool.
So then I did a mixed fermentation. I used Verdant IPA yeast, and I did a mixed fermentation where I started the fermentation, and then about halfway, you know, when the fermentation started was about 24 hours. I actually put it under pressure or capped it off and put it under pressure and then fermented the rest of the way. At 10 PSI. But what I did before I capped it off was I actually put in 2 ounces of Eclipse in there for what's called a biotransformation dry hopping. So basically where the hops interact with the yeast while it's fermenting and stuff. If you do an early addition like that, that kind of contributes to some of the haze, as a matter of fact. And then after everything slowed down quite a bit, I put another 2 ounces of Citra in there. And I did that basically at a no oxygen dump with a device that I've got. And then I chilled it down to 55 degrees with like a jacket that I had around. I used a Spike Flex fermenter and I put a jacket around
this
there.
Is it?
Yeah, this is it. That's
like
it.
Step number 153.
Right,
Holy
exactly.
crap.
The things we do for beer. Hey, leave us a comment down below. You know, like I said, I don't do a lot of grain to glass videos and stuff like that. But if you got, you guys like these kind of videos where we kind of review stuff that we've done, you know, like beers we brewed or whatever, leave a comment down below. Hit a thumbs up if you like that stuff, because, you know, that lets us know you'd like to see more of these. I certainly do. I enjoy doing them, but I want to know if you guys enjoy them. So let me know down below. So what I did was I chilled it down to 55 degrees. And the interesting thing, the jacket that I had was for cooling, it sprung a leak sometime in the middle of the night. I came down one morning to check on everything, and it was like, right. It was whizzing.
And our cat is like,
yeah, right. No. So, and then I just transferred it over to keg, and I didn't use a Blichmann quick carb or anything out this time. I just did a burst carbonation where I cranked up the PSI for 25 PSI for about 24 hours. And then the carbonation was perfect. So, I actually poured these beers a little bit before we started the video, because you really want to drink this kind of beer at about 45 degrees.
Oh, okay.
That's when all of the aromas and the flavors and everything come out the most. So I want you to tell me, like, what aromas and everything you get out of it. Put the aroma test on it and let me know what you smell.
Well, let's see. Citra. I have a nose for that, though. I can't tell anything else, actually.
Now I will tell you, I smell the citra as well.
It smells delicious.
Yeah, right. there's a lot of, you know, orange and grapefruit and those kind of notes in there. Mm-hmm. But I will tell you, the eclipse, one of the descriptors on the eclipse says pine. And I do get a little bit of pine in there.
I almost said Columbus, but you didn't mention that.
No, I just use eclipse and citra only in this thing. It was just
Columbus
like a too hot beer.
Piney, isn't it? Piney tasting?
Yeah, a little bit. It has a little bit of pininess to it. But yeah, I do pick up a little bit of that pine. So let's get the taste on it and see what we got. Cheers.
Cheers. It's mild. It's nice. I like it. It's got a good finish.
So what are you tasting?
Like orange peel. I don't taste the honey though.
I think the honey gives it what I detect. Well. There's a little bit of color in the honey malt, but it gives it a little bit of sweetness too. And I think that's one of the things, like when I take the first sip of it, like the first drink, I get that sweetness. And then it's like, it's weird because the way that I like doing first wort hopping for bittering, because it just kind of creeps on your palate. You know, you get this kind of a sweetness, and then that bitterness just starts to kind of rise up and you get that. And then it's like, oh my gosh, now I got to take another sip.
A big IPA person.
Yeah, she didn't like IPAs much at all. it is really nice and hazy. I'll give you guys a little view here.
Party.
But it's really hazy. And it's been in the keg. This stuff has been in the keg for probably, I think, maybe a week, a little over a week, something like that. Mm-hmm. And the haze is maintained, and, you know, everything went good. I did
it is refreshing. It's lighter in the palate, so it's like, it's...
Yeah.
It's a good...
Yeah, I think the IBUs on it were like 38 IBUs.
Refreshing beer.
If I'm not mistaken, here, let me see. I got a can of it here. Yeah, so the original gravity was 1.064. Final gravity was 1.016. I brewed it on 1023 and then just canned this today, and ABV was 6.2%. So yeah, there's the cans from October that I put it in. I'll have a review coming out on that at some point. But so that's the stats on it. And I think this came out really well. I will share it down in the description below. Let you guys, if you want to brew it, check it out, try it. I mean, I think for what I got out of this beer, I've had a lot of other hazy recipes that have been a lot more expensive because of the amount of hops in them and everything. And I don't know that I was as pleased as I am with this one. What's that?
This is a New England, though, right?
Yeah, it's a New England IPA. Oh. But yeah, so I've brewed some other hazy beers that had multiple layers of hops and everything on them. And, you know, I'm a sucker for citrus.
Are all hazy New England?
Pretty much. Yeah. I mean, unless you're talking about like a wheat beer or something like that, but a hazy IPA would be kind of that New England style was popularized by Hetty Topper and some of the other breweries over there. But so that's the overview or review follow up on the Breweasy Compact Brew Day beer that I made.
I think people would like it.
This has been Brian.
And Kelly.
For Short Circuited Brewers. When will we see him?
On
the next video. On the next video.
On the next video.
All right. Cheers, everybody.
Let me just put my sleeves up.